guys, what's up and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm super excited to be doing another Mom Reacts video. I'm going to be reacting to some scenes that are depicting moms going into labor. And as we all know, television and movies, they just don't always accurately represent or depict labor, delivery, and birth. And a lot of people use these movies and television depictions to draw on what they think labor and delivery and birth and everything will be like. And it's just simply not true a lot of the time. Sometimes it's just a little much, just not accurate. There are shows and movies and stuff that do a really good job, in my opinion, of depicting all these events, but there are also a lot of other TV shows, movies, that kind of thing, that just do a really bad job. And so if you were like me before you had your first baby or whatever, you didn't know what to expect, you really just went off of what Hollywood told you, which probably is just not right. So anyway, we're just gonna jump right into it. The first thing I'm gonna be reacting to is the end scene from Steel Magnolias, a movie that I love with all my heart, and it's just classic and I love it. But the end scene, one of the characters is going into labor. She's very great with child, and yeah, it's always just been a little extra, a little just maybe not correct. But anyway, I just love this movie, so let's jump into it.
Is he alright?
He's alright.
Yeah, so I just love that scene. I love this movie. Like I said, it's a classic movie, and I just love it. And I love Dolly Parton, and I have to say, I love the maternity wear, whatever year this came out. I think it was before I was in the mid-80s, so yeah. But yeah, I just think it's kind of funny. At the beginning, I really enjoy how she is portraying that. She's just so big and just tired. That's what I got. Like, if you've been there, you know how it feels. You just can't do anything. You can't sleep. You can't breathe. You can't sit comfortably. You can't, you just can't do anything. And so she portrayed the tired really well. But then all of a sudden, it just seemed like it switched from I'm tired to oh no, from breathing like that. It was kind of like a oh okay, I'm not in labor. Oh, all of a sudden I'm in labor. Oh no. And then I love Weeza, the character on here, who's like, she's having a baby, somebody call a doctor. Like, they're just, everybody's freaking out all of a sudden, like, because the mom shows some sort of inkling of a contraction or labor or whatever. I just kind of think this scene is a little bit overdone, and yeah, in my experience, labor starts off slow and very mild. It starts off like just, you know, normal menstrual cramps is what the contractions felt like for me. You know, that would intensify as the as labor progressed and everything like that. It wasn't just something like I was just sitting there and then all of a sudden labor, what is this, right? So yeah, I don't know. To me, the scene's a little overdone. Obviously, it's an older movie, so it's a little more theatrical, a little more stage-like, a little more what have you. But yeah, usually, I think like 99% of the time, I mean, I'm not the authority on birth and all that, but 99% of the time, I believe it starts mildly and then will intensify until the end. And so yeah, if you're worried about spontaneous labor, don't worry about just being like, I'm not in labor. No, I'm in labor. So yeah. So the next scene I'm going to
going to react to is going to be Skyler from Breaking Bad going into labor. And as you know, Breaking Bad is a lot newer than Steel Magnolias. It has the same kind of effect here. And you'll see as you watch the scene about how she goes into labor and whatnot. But I do see how people could think this is a little more realistic. Like, if I had never had a baby before, never known what to expect about the gradual increase in intensity of the contractions and all that jazz, I could buy this and think, whoa, I wanted to go into spontaneous labor, but I don't know if I want to if it's like that. So check out this clip from Breaking Bad as Skyler's going into labor. So she's sitting at work at her desk, seemingly normal, not in labor, and then just, yeah, draw your own conclusions from this. The acting is a little more realistic. It's not as theatrical, obviously. But here again, we have somebody just sitting and seemingly normal, not having any movement, action, just kind of bored at work. And all of a sudden, labor just punches them in the uterus, apparently, so to speak.
Ow!
I will say, I really like her acting. I was like, I could dig, like, you know, if that contraction had, like, happened, like, you know, active transition phase or whatever. That was great acting. I still just don't think, you know, even then, that you can feel the contraction coming on. It's not just something that's like knife in the gut, you know. It's not quite like that. And also, her character has a son who's like 20 years old. So you would think she would have an inkling of what labor was like. Like, you know, she's like has this weird thing, like, you know, and then all of a sudden, then she's like getting punched again. But it's like, you think you would know what labor is like. You have another child, you've done this before, like, you know what I'm saying? But I don't know, it just seemed a little far-fetched to me. Like, again, I say, reiterate, if you're trying to do spontaneous labor, I'm thinking 99.9% of the time it's not like that. It starts out very gradually. It starts out mild and then it increases in intensity. Okay, now, like I said, I'm not an authority on birth. I don't know, I'm not the main authority on birth, but I do know that it's just, that was a little bit extra, if you ask me.
Yeah, that's right.
Okay, and so the last scene that I want to react to is from a sitcom, so obviously it's going to be a little more theatrical, so to speak, but it's from the sitcom Reba. I love this sitcom. I have watched it through probably like 20 times, which is like shamefaced, but whatever. I love it. It's one of my favorite ones. And in the first season, Reba's daughter is pregnant and she's going into labor, and this puts Reba in a flashback of when she went to labor, into labor, or something like that. So we're going to be watching the scene where Reba is in labor. And I want to point out some cool things about this scene when we do it. Well, let's just do it. I love her hair. I like the big hair and the bangs. I can never do bangs. Like, I think straight across bangs are trendy, but my forehead is very, very little. So, yeah. Oh, just love Reba. And I really love Dolly Parton, too.
Okay. Dr. Schmidt's gonna meet us at the hospital. I got the video camera, your suitcase, and the box of cigars. Let's go.
I'm not going. I've changed my mind.
You're in labor. I don't think you can do that.
So first plus for this scene is the fact that we know she's in labor and she's resting. Looks like she's not contracting. Which is a very typical thing of labor. If you've never labored before, you will have a contraction and then you will have a rest period. And if I remember correctly from my birth class that I took, you will rest more than you will contract. So be encouraged about that. If you're freaking out about labor, add it all up together. You really rest way more than you contract. But yeah, she's resting. So yay, sitcom, you already got something right. That's awesome. Good job. Dad's gathering everything up. Kind of liking it.
I was thinking about something Mama said when I was going off to college.
Should we really be stopping for stories right now? Yes, we should.
If you're birthing Mama, it's all about you. Just want you to know that, okay?
Mama said you bring a child into the world, you change their diapers, you nurse them when they're sick, you fight with them when they're teenagers, and when they've finally grown up to become your friend, they leave.
Don't you think by the time graduation rolls around for this little one, he might be ready to let go?
I can't take that chance.
I tell you what, if after 18 years we're not fully sick of this child, we'll lock him or her in a closet and never let him leave.
We could use the hall closet.
I think this is funny because it reminds me of my actual labor with my son. My water had broken and I was having contractions that were like menstrual cramps. They were not even like, you know, contractions, you know. And anyway, some family member was on the way to pick up our daughter. And I remember having like an emotional mental like meltdown because I was like, I can't do this. I can't love another child. Like I love our daughter and I just can't. Like this is crazy. What am I gonna do? And then my husband's like, it's fine. It's cool. You know, we're gonna do this. You're gonna love it. And all this kind of stuff, which by the way, love my son so much. Like any fears you may have regarding that, just discount them. Your heart just will grow and grow and grow. So anyway, but I remember this specific scene like being played out like in my labor, this specific scene, this one right there, being played out in my labor with my son. So I thought it was kind of funny that it was in this clip I picked.
Fine. Now, can we go have this baby? You know, I got a strong hunch it's a boy.
Yeah, so obviously she's having the contraction again and it kind of hits a little sudden as well. I still am going to say contractions are gradual, whether they may feel different. I know that with my daughter, when I was induced and I had Pitocin and all that, the contractions really started in the back and they would wrap around to the front. With my son, they kind of stayed in the lower region, like, you know, where you have menstrual cramps, and they just always stayed there and didn't do the wrapping around thingy, but they did grow in intensity. I would feel it down my legs and just kind of everywhere at that point. Yeah, they were kind of sudden. It looked like she was reacting suddenly to that, and I understand it is a sitcom and that's fine. It is what it is, but I have to say that this clip from Reba is probably the best birth depiction, the most accurate birth depiction, realistically, that we've seen out of this video, out of the three videos I'm reacting to. Yay Reba, yay sitcom, woohoo! So yeah, basically, if you are wanting to go into a natural, spontaneous labor, please note that it is not like the Steel Magnolias and it is not like the Breaking Bad scene. It's going to be a gradual increase of intensity and it's not just going to be like you're sitting there eating a salad and all of a sudden, boom, you're in labor and then like you're in labor so much that you're like in active transition phase or whatever. So don't freak out about that. I know with my first, with my daughter, I wanted to do natural spontaneous labor. But I went ahead and went in for an induction at 41 weeks. So didn't experience that, but with my son, I did. My water broke and then contraction started like an hour after that and it was like a mild menstrual cramp and then it just intensified until the end. So it wasn't scary, it wasn't like these depictions. So if you're worried that that's gonna happen, just know it's probably not. Like I said, I'm not the authority on all the births. I don't know. Comment below if you actually experienced that and that's a thing. And let me know I'm wrong. I don't know. But I think generally most of the time it's a gradual increase. Now I know that there are super short labors and that there are and then there are normal, like medium in the middle labors, like as far as length and whatnot. So yeah, everybody's different, but I'm pretty sure most of the time it's not like I'm not in labor. So yeah, don't let that worry you. So anyway, I hope you guys liked this video. If you did, I hope you subscribe to my channel and click that bell notification to be notified when I upload another video. And if you want to see me react to something else, comment below, let me know what it is. I know I've got some Call the Midwife coming up and more Handmaid's Tale and just a bunch of other things. I mean, there's birth depictions everywhere. So I will definitely be coming back with some more mom reacts. Also, I want to plug my other vlog channel. If you want to see DIY experiments with like crafty stuff, music covers, challenge stuff, vlogging about life, head on over to Melissa Champion Vlogs and subscribe there and click that notification on there too, because I just do a bunch of random stuff over there. I would love to have you be a part of that channel. So anyway, until next time, I will see you guys in the next video. Goodbye, friends.